Good evening, my dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are fine. Today I am going to discuss about the chromosomal disorders. I think that you all have gone through the previous chapters I have discussed earlier. Today we are going to start the unit 15 of our syllabus in child health nursing, that is from the genetics. So our today's topic is chromosomal disorders. As you all know, you have already studied some chromosomal disorders from the plus 2 itself. The major chromosomal disorders that we are going to discuss today are Down syndrome, then Edwards syndrome, Pato syndrome, Turner syndrome and Klinefelter syndrome. So first we are going to discuss about the Down syndrome. So before that, you have to we can revise something that you have already studied in the previous classes, that is about the some terminologies that we are commonly using in the genetic disorders. First one is gene. Gene, what is gene? Gene is the smallest unit of a single characteristic. That is, it is the smallest unit of a single characteristic or a single trait of our body. That is our genetic features. Okay, it is the smallest unit of a single genetic characteristic. Then chromosome. Chromosome is a structural element in the cell nucleus that carry the genes and convey the genetic information. So it is the chromosome is the structural element. Okay, it is a structural element in the nucleus of the cell that carry, okay, this chromosome is a carrier of the genes and they are conveying the genetic information. Okay, so the gene is orderly arranged in the chromosome. So each cell except the RBO contain all of the chromosomes from both the parents in the nucleus. So there are 23 pairs of chromosomes coming from each parent. You all know we have 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs of chromosomes. We are getting 23 chromosomes among that 46 chromosomes from the mother and then the other 23 chromosomes from the father. So these chromosomes that we are getting from the mother and the father is getting paired. And it will finally form into a chromosomal pattern of 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs. Then autosome, another terminology in genetics is autosome. Autosome means one of the 22 pairs of chromosome that is not responsible for determining the sex of the child. Okay, so there are two types of chromosome, autosomal chromosomes and sex chromosome. So in our body, among the 23 pairs of chromosome, all the 22 chromosomes are not responsible for determining the sex of the child, but the sex chromosome means X and Y chromosomes are responsible for the sex determination. That is, only one pair of chromosome is determining the sex of the child. Other 22 chromosomes are not determining the sex of the child. That is known as autosome. That is, in our body there are 22 pairs of autosome and one pair of sex chromosome. The sex chromosome is determining the sex of the child by the presence of X and Y. The next is chromosomal defects. Chromosomal defects means there are various chromosomal defects. That is, the major chromosomal defects are abnormal number, mosaicism and abnormal structure. What are the chromosomal defects? Abnormal number, mosaicism and abnormal structure. In abnormal number, the first one is monosomy. Monosomy. Monosomy means what? Actually, the chromosome is paired. That means diploid. Okay, I have already told you that the pair of chromosome is formulating by the one chromosome from father and one chromosome from mother. So monosomy means one less than the diploid number. Actually, our chromosome is diploid in nature. Diploid means pair. Always the chromosome are in pairs. But if in any of the one chromosome is missing from a pair, okay? If any of the chromosome is missing from a pair, it is known as monosomy. So one less than the diploid number. Actually, there should be 46 chromosomes in our body. But if there is a missing chromosome, there will be only 45 chromosomes in our body and it is known as monosomy. Okay, so I'm simply telling the child with or a condition in which the one of the chromosome is missing, it is known as monosomy and that particular person will have only 45 chromosomes. The next is trisomy. Trisomy means one more than the diploid number. That means if there is an extra chromosome other than the 46 chromosome, it is known as trisomy, and the particular person will have total of 47 chromosomes instead of the normal 46 chromosome. Okay, normally a person have 46 chromosome, but if there is an extra chromosome, the person will have 47 chromosome, and the condition is known as trisomy. The next is mosaicism. Mosaicism, I think, have you all noticed the mosaic? Mosaic means what? It is a the pattern of mosaic is like it is mixed. There is not a particular pattern. So some cells have the correct number of chromosome and some have more or less than the correct number of chromosome. That is, it may be mixed. And there will not be any particular arrangement for that chromosome. Okay, actually, this chromosome are meticulously beaded. Meticulously beaded means it is correctly placed on the strand of the DNA, isn't it? You have seen the helical strand of the DNA. So it was picturized, or it was found out by Watson and Crick. You have all know. So in this DNA, it is meticulously beaded, or it is carefully arranged. So the position of the chromosome must not be changed. If it is changed, then it will cause certain chromosomal disorder. So in mosaicism, there may or may not be correct number of chromosomes, but it is mixed. Then abnormal structure. Abnormal structure means deletion. There is a condition called deletion. Deletion means there is a loss of chromosomal segment. One of the chromosomal segment is completely lost. We can't find the lost chromosome anywhere. The next is translocation. Translocation means the occurrence of a chromosomal segment at an abnormal site, either on another chromosome or in the wrong position. I have already told you that this chromosome is meticulously beaded, or it is carefully arranged on the strands of the DNA. So if the segment is abnormally located, or it is connected to a wrong position, then it is known as translocation. From the word itself, you can understand what is translocation. The next is prenatal diagnosis. So we can diagnose the chromosomal disorders prenatally itself. The first diagnosis is maternal serum alpha protein. Maternal serum alpha protein, or MSAFP. That we are doing this maternal serum alpha protein, we can do it in the 16th to 18th week of gestation. So it can be this serum alpha protein we can assess through the blood test. So if there is high maternal serum alpha protein, it means incorrect date, or the mother is pregnant. Then multiple gestation, that means more than two children in one pregnancy. Then if there is an inural tube defect, the serum alpha protein will be high. Then abdominal wall defects to the child. We have already discussed the abdominal wall defect like gastroschisis, omphalocele and all in gastrointestinal disorders. Then renal anomalies. Then esophageal or intestinal obstruction. These all conditions of the child, as well as the incorrect date or the pregnancy of the mother, can be determined by high maternal serum alpha protein. Then multiple gestation, neural tube defects. Then if there is low maternal serum alpha protein, it is also due to the incorrect date of the mother. Then chromosomal defect like trisomy 21. In trisomy 21, the maternal serum alpha protein will be less than normal. Then next, we can find out the chromosomal disorders through ultrasound scanning, that is especially the physical defects. Then next is amniocentesis. Amniocentesis means, what is it? Amniocentesis means we are withdrawing the amniotic fluid. Okay, we are withdrawing the amniotic fluid from the uterus during the pregnancy of the mother. It is usually done in the 16th to 18th week of gestation, and the fluid analysis may require up to 2 to 3 weeks. That means we have to wait for 2 to 3 weeks for the results, and it can usually determine the fetal sex. Fetal sex can be determined through amniocentesis, but we are not using it to identify the fetal sex. We are not usually doing this performance because it is we are not usually doing this procedure because it is an invasive procedure. So we can determine the fetal sex. Then metabolic disorders, if there is any metabolic disorders to the child, and if there is any chromosomal abnormalities, we can find it out from the amniocentesis. Then next is chorionic villi sampling. So chorionic villi sampling, we are assessing the we are collecting the fluid from the amniotic fluid, and it is usually done at the 8th to 10th week of gestation, and we can do fetal cell analysis. And it usually takes 24 to 48 hours. That means the result will take up to 2 days. The next is triple test. We can do triple test and quadruple test to find out this chromosomal abnormalities. Triple test means there are usually we are performing three tests. We are analyzing three tests, that is maternal serum markers. From the maternal serum, we are finding out three factors like alpha beta protein, then unconjugated estriol, and human chorionic gonadotrophy. Okay, so the maternal serum markers, the main maternal serum markers in the triple test are three tests. That is, we are testing for alpha beta protein, unconjugated estriol, and human chorionic gonadotrophin. If the alpha beta protein is low, the child is having Down syndrome. And if the unconjugated estriol is low also, it is Down syndrome. The next is quadruple test. Quadruple test means we are checking the four markers of the maternal serum. That is alpha fetoprotein, then unconjugated estriol, then human chorionic gonadotrophin, and pregnancy associated plasma protein A. Okay, actually pregnancy associated plasma protein A is absent in the mothers who are bearing normal children or normal babies. So, in quadruple test, we are assessing alpha fetoprotein, then unconjugated estriol, then human chorionic gonadotrophin, and pregnancy associated plasma protein A. The next is FISH test. FISH test means fluorescent in situ hybridization. That is, we are performing in the lab. That is, it is done in 18 to 20 weeks, and the fetal cells are obtained, and they are subject. We can obtain the fetal cells from amniocentesis or chorionic villi sampling, and it is, they are subjected to chromosomal analysis. That is FISH test. The next is newborn care. So what care we are providing to the newborn? First of all, we are checking the family history. We are collecting the family history. We are collecting the history for similar history for any relatives and frequency of spontaneous abortions. Then, and also any prenatal history like fetal activity, maternal exposures, then maternal exposure to any infections or any toxins or any drugs, then uterine malformation, we all are collecting it. Okay, so these all are the test as well as the care that we are providing in all chromosomal disorders. And the first chromosomal disorder we are going to discuss is trisomy 21 or Down syndrome. Okay. So, from the word itself, we can say that it is a trisomy 21. Trisomy means an extra chromosome along with a pair of chromosome. So, on the 21st pair of chromosome, there will be an extra chromosome. That is known as trisomy 21 or Down syndrome. So, Down syndrome is the most common cause of mental retardation and malformation in the newborn. So, there are certain associated congenital disorders along with the Down syndrome. So, Down syndrome is the most common cause of mental retardation and malformation in a newborn. It occurs because of the presence of an extra 21st chromosome, and it was first described in 1866 by Dr. John L.H. Down. So this syndrome is known as Down syndrome for along with the name of that physician. So Dr. John L.H. Down. So instance, Down syndrome occurs about once in every 800 births. It is estimated that 10,000 children are born with Down syndrome each year in India. The causes are increased maternal age, that is 30 plus. Then parents with chromosomal disorders, if there is any previous history or any chromosomal disorders already. Then hereditary, then chromosomal mutation, if there is any mutation because of the exposure to any drugs or any radiations. Then types of Down syndrome are mosaic Down syndrome and translocation Down syndrome. There are two types of Down syndrome, mosaic Down syndrome and translocation Down syndrome. First is mosaic Down syndrome. Here, the original egg and sperm cells are completely normal. In mosaicism or mosaic Down syndrome, the original egg or the ovum and the sperm cells are completely normal. The problem occurs sometimes shortly after fertilization. Shortly after fertilization, there may be some problem during the phase where the cells are dividing rapidly. During the time of mitosis and meiosis, there may be some problems, and one cell divides abnormally, creating a line of cells with an extra chromosome 21. Okay, here there will not be any problem to the any genetic disorders or chromosomal disorders to the mother and father, or the egg or ovum and sperm will be normal. But during the short time after fertilization, there will be cell division because of mitosis and meiosis, and at that time there may be some changes in the division of cells, and it will divide abnormally to create a line of cells with an extra chromosome 21. This forms a genetic disorder called mosaic Down syndrome. The next is translocation Down syndrome. During the cell division, the number 21st chromosome somehow breaks. Here there is breakdown. In mosaic Down syndrome, there is attachment of an extra line of chromosome. But here, in translocation Down syndrome, there is breakdown of the cell division. Then the 21st chromosome somehow breaks. A piece of the 21st chromosome then becomes attached to another chromosome. That is translocation of the 21st chromosome to another chromosome. Each cell still has 46 chromosome, but the extra piece of chromosome 21, resulting in Down syndrome. Here if you are seeing, the child will have 46 chromosomes, but the 21st chromosome is detached from the normal position and it is attached to other position. And finally if you are taking the chromosome for analysis, there will be correct 46 chromosome, but the 21st chromosome will be attached to another chromosome, causing trisomy. So it results in Down syndrome due to translocation. In clinical presentation are small size, they are small in size, and 20% of the children are premature. Then the skull will be short and round with a flat occiput, separated sutures. Then eyes will be slant upward and downward. Sometimes the eyes will be upward, sometimes it will be downward. Then the prominent epicanthal fold. Epicanthus, where is the epicanthus? That is folds of the eyes. Prominent epicanthal folds, moon-shaped face, then brush field spot. I have already told you in the newborn examination, that is brush field spot means the around the retina there will be a whitish circle like the tip of the brush. Then cheeks will be red, palate will be narrow. The palates will be narrow and short. Roof of the mouth will be narrow and short. The nose will be short with flat bridges. Tongue will be protruding, or tongue is thrusting. Thrusting means it will be protruding out, or it will be clinging out. Then skin will be loose around the lateral and dorsal aspects of the neck. Then hands of the fingers are short. Hands are square in shape. Then thumbs are lozenged. The thumbs will be lozenged. That is, the thumbs will be very short in size. Then separated more than usual from the second finger. That is, if you are taking the thumb finger, that is if you are taking the thumb finger of the leg, then we can see that the toe and the second finger, the distance will be more. There is a much distance between both these fingers. Then the fifth finger is short and curves inward. Then single or bilateral simian creases. Then you can see the figure later. Then ears are lozenged ears. Then posteriorly rotated ears. Posteriorly rotated means how it will be. That means the ear will be rotated, or ear will be curved to the front. Then other clinical presentations are umbilical. There will be umbilical herniation. The feet will be wide space between great toe and the second toe. There will be wide space between the great toe and the second toe. And also while taking the hand, there will be space between the first thumb and the second finger. Then deep creases between great toe and the second toe. Flat feet. Then if you are taking the heart, there will be congenital disorders like ventricular septal defect. Then duodenal atresia, narrowing of the duodenum. Then muscular hypotonia. Then retarded psychomotor development. Then hyperlaxity of the ligaments. Then velvety, loose, adhering, mottled skin in infancy. Coarse skin in adolescence. Then mouth frequently open or frequently open mouth. That is, mouth will be open always. Then visual or hearing impairment. Then other clinical manifestations are growth failure, mental retardation, then flat back of the head, abnormal ears, then many loops on fingertips, palm creases, then special skin ridge patterns. Already we have discussed it before. You can see it in the diagram. Then Mongolian face. Then management are supportive care, symptomatic treatment, and correction of associated disorders. So the symptomatic management for the neurological manifestations are anticonvulsant for seizures. There are some associated neurological manifestations like seizures. So we can give anticonvulsants. Then for developmental delay, early intervention is needed. Then physiotherapy for gross or fine motor deficits. Then we can provide speech therapy because they have some speech disorders. Then special education for learning disabilities because they are mentally retarded too. So mental health assistance and family counseling. Then management in respiratory and cardiac problems, the cardiology consultation and echo during the first week after birth to find out the congenital disorders properly, congenital heart disorders. Then surgical correction of congenital heart disease. Then sleep apnea. If there is sleep apnea, we have to reduce the weight, repositioning during sleep. We can, they are overweight, so we have to reduce the weight and we can reposition them during the sleep. Then tonsillectomy and adenoidectomy. Then if there is any dermatological problems, application of moisturizers, hypoallergenic creams, steroid creams for curing eczema. Then give all vaccines on time. Okay. Then administer pneumococcal and influenza vaccines because they are more prone to respiratory infections. Then parental counseling should be needed because they are, the parents are not aware of the care of its children and they don't know how to manage their children. Then environmental enrichment, then sensory stimulation care has to be given. Then exercise for gross or fine motor development. Then pre-vocational training that we have, that means we can give vocational training by sending them to special schools. Then prognosis are the congestive heart failure. That means congestive cardiac failure because of the congestive congenital heart diseases, there will be congestive heart failure. Then upper respiratory tract infections is common among children with Down syndrome. Then they are developmentally delayed. Then mildly to severely mentally retarded, that is the IQ will be ranging only from 25 to 70. They may be mildly or severely mentally retarded. Then increased risk for thyroid problems and leukemia. Okay, so these are all about the Down syndrome. Hope you all understood my class, and we will continue with the other chromosomal disorders in the next class. Thank you.